Hello, my beautiful Scorpio. Welcome to your Valentine's Day, second half of Feb 2024 love reading. I hope you're doing well. Based on the pre-shuffle, very interesting cards actually. I feel like some of you could have met someone very unexpectedly. We've got unexpected connection. Someone who might not be your usual type, or maybe you just met them out of nowhere and it randomly transpired. I'm seeing light-hearted, playful energy here. Things are quite fun but uncertain. Okay, we have the tease card. I feel like you know this might just be a fleeting love. You might just be passing the time with this person, having some fun with this person. You might suspect that they could be seeing someone else, or I'm not really quite sure about this third party card. I'm gonna have to do some digging with the tarot. I'm sensing that some of you might have an ex come back on the scene, and that could be the third party as well. But yeah, we'll leave that one on hold for just a moment. I'm seeing a very physical connection, possibly with someone who's younger than you, or there could be a considerable age gap between you and this person because we have forever young. Your romance sings with joy as you surrender to your youthful playfulness, but I'm getting someone that could be younger. Physical connection, it says, yeah, the sacred union of bodies. Okay, lots of chemistry here, but there's something definitely that's hidden. There's something that you don't know. We've got disguise, so we will have to do some digging into this, but it is a healing connection. I feel like some of you were just going about your day. You could have been trying to manifest something more serious, you know, because Scorpios really aren't inclined to go for something that's casual, something that's fleeting. But you know, we have needs too, and it's nice to feel desired. It's nice to have a bit of fun every now and then, but I do feel like this connection does offer some kind of healing. And says your romance is a deep learning experience that will transform your life. Okay, so let's have a look. There's two things I really want to focus on. It's what this and who this third party is, and what could be hidden in this connection. So we'll divert to the tarot and see if we can get some clearer answers. Okay, let's start with this person's true feelings and intentions towards you. Yeah, I feel like this person is holding back something. They're not very open when it comes to their feelings or intentions. You could be kind of like, you know, just guessing, playing guesswork as to what this person intends towards you, what they have to offer, what they want to offer. Let me see. Angels and spirit, please show me. How does this person feel towards Scorpio, and what are their true intentions? I feel like they see you as the Nine of Pentacles. They admire you, they look up to you, they put you on a bit of a pedestal, they find you quite attractive. But they are hiding something. I keep getting this Seven of Swords energy. This person struggles with initiating. I feel like they don't really know what to do or say in some instances. All right. We have the Lovers. They might have to make a decision between you and someone from their past. So it could be one of their exes still on the scene. What is this? Show me, please, Spirit. I'm getting that they might not be ready for the type of relationship. Yeah, I'm getting... this person might not be ready for a full-on relationship, and I feel like many of you already know that. Yeah, that's what I'm getting. With the Five of Pentacles, this person might have some financial problems. Angels and Spirit, please show me. What is this person's true feelings and intentions towards Scorpio? I feel like the slow moving energy around this person, they could be a little bit cautious. Show me this person's true feelings and intentions. Yeah, I'm getting delay tactics with the Seven of Pentacles in the reverse, but they really don't know what you're looking for. I feel like that's a half of it. That's half of it. Again, I feel like they put you up on a pedestal. They feel like they don't know where they come in when it comes to your life, because I feel like you're pretty well sorted. You're sitting pretty, you're well established, and this person may not know what it is that they want. We have the Seven of Cups. Yeah, I feel like you're a lot more established within yourself, is what I'm getting here, okay? I'm not getting so much that this person wants to keep their options open. I'm not really getting that. I'm just getting that they're a bit confused as to the direction that they're headed. We have the Two of Cups in the reverse. It's just reinforcing the fact that I don't feel they're ready for a full-blown relationship as such. Okay? Yeah. Show me this person's feelings towards Scorpio. Yeah, they feel like they don't have what it takes to make you happy. We've got the Magician in the reverse. Yeah. They do a lot of thinking. Yeah, they don't know if they have what it takes to give you what you want. There's a bit of inadequacy here with this person. Yeah, and they don't know how to move forward. We have the Six of Swords in the reverse position. Okay. Have a look at this person's vices. Show me this person's vices, please. Scorpio's person's vices. Anxiety, I feel like their thoughts are turbulent. They're an overthinker is what I'm getting. And there's a lot of fear around this person. That's what I was getting with the tarot. But yeah, they're fearful. Maybe you intimidate them a little bit, but I'm getting it's beyond this connection. They have a lot of fears. Maybe around failure. Can we please this person's... They could live life on the edge. I'm getting recklessness, you know, taking unnecessary risks, making poor decisions, not valuing the sanctity of life. I do feel like this person likes attention. We've got fame lust. Okay. You know, they seek out approval and validation because there's inadequacies there with them. There's some insecurities. And we've got role play. It kind of stands to reason. If this person isn't comfortable in their own skin and they've got some deep-seated insecurities, they're going to be wearing a mask. They're going to be pretending that they know who they are and what they want, but they don't really, okay? That's what I'm getting. I'm not getting anything too offensive with this person. Let's have a look at this third party. What is this third party? What's Scorpio's person of interest, please? Second half of Feb 2024. What is this third party, please, Spirit? What is this third party? It could be holding on to someone or hoping that something happens again with an ex. Okay. Who is this third party, please, Spirit? Who is this third party? Walked away from or that walked away from them, there's unfinished business. Yeah, they still have to release this person. I feel like they could still be holding on to them when they're making plans with you. So I definitely feel like there's unfinished business here and they haven't been completely transparent with you about it. You might be completely unaware that they're still holding on to this person. This person that they're holding on to could be in and out of their life. They could be off traveling, I'm getting for some. Yeah, that's what I'm getting. So they're hoping that this person's going to return, and they're hoping for the possibility of a reunion with this person. Let's have a look at your advice. Yeah, prepare for a plot twist. I feel like this person could have been a plot twist for you. You really weren't expecting to meet them, and you're thinking life is infinitely stranger than anything that the mind could invent. Let's see, angels and spirit, please show me what is the advice for Scorpio. I keep seeing the number 10. I don't know if that is significant. Maybe you met this person on the 10th of Feb, or I don't know, there's something around the number 10. Okay, there's something that this person's hiding from you, but I feel like you already have a clue as to what it is. And even if you don't, you've got a card that says spirit will always reveal what needs to be revealed and do what needs to be done. Okay, I do see healing with this person. I'm seeing alchemy, which is, you know, healing. It's turning sadness into art. It's turning anger into healthier boundaries. And I feel like you're helping this person to heal as well. Maybe you're a catalyst in this person's life. Show me, please, Spirit, what does Scorpio need to know regarding love in second half of Feb 2024? Right, here we go. The guidance is to give to this person without any form of expectation, because, you know, this person can't hurt you because you're in charge of your own feelings. Just have boundaries intact. It says, if you don't feel that you deserve to be respected, you're much more likely to suffer from the actions of others who need to be told that they've gone too far. So just put boundaries in place. I'm getting that this person isn't being totally honest with you out of fear that you might reject them or judge them in some way. It's a means of control for this person. They can control the narrative and control how you might act towards them. Because when we withhold or distort the truth, we're impacting on how the other person can or will behave. All right, so this untruth that they're kind of peddling to you right now is out of fear. Okay, let's have a look at your crystal spirit message in love. What is Scorpio's message in love, please? Alright, so you've got Moldavite, and the message is transformation, rebirth through fire, initiation and opening to new experiences, revitalization and renewal. It says, as you transition to a new you, you'll become part of a new group of people, for you are having new experiences that differ from those that came before. Old friends will be there for you, but new ones will appear, drawn to your vibration, which resonates with theirs. Although you're being initiated into a new experience, you will not be alone, so leave your fears at the door. Your community will find you, and you'll know that you belong as they embrace you as one of their own. You will feel the love as you adjust to your new role, confident in the potential of those you care about coming along with you. Encourage them to believe that they too can let go of the past and transition into something better. So many of you Scorpios you're moving into a period of change, whether you're actually moving physically, moving home, moving employment. You will be meeting new people and love prospects. So many of you will have come across this person due to some kind of life change. Let me know in the comments if that's true for you. Let's see where you were most likely to encounter this person. It's going to be different for everyone, but let's just see. Angels and Spirit, please show me where was the most likely place that Scorpio has encountered this person. Show me clearly. You were on your way somewhere, it looks like. Please show me. For some of you, it could have been in some kind of an establishment. I'm seeing drinks and beverages, pub food. We've got tavern here, but it doesn't necessarily have to be like an actual tavern. Show me please where Scorpio is likely to have encountered this person. Got coffee house, so maybe a coffee, you were grabbing your coffee before work or somewhere. Yeah, shopping mall. I feel like you were on a mission, you were on your way to grab something. Maybe you were on an errand, running an errand. For some of you, yeah, we've got a rendezvous point. Maybe you were waiting to meet up with someone. It was some kind of convergence, some kind of meeting place. Could have been near the water for many of you. Yeah, you were on your way somewhere. I'm not sure if this came up in your last reading, but look, elevator. We get into an elevator when we're going somewhere. So I feel like you were in transit. Stopping on your way somewhere. We've got kitchen here. So definitely could have been while you were picking up a coffee or a bite to eat, a snack, something like that. Let me know if that resonates with you. Okay. Let's see. I'm just going to get some general messages to close out the reading. What is the message for Scorpio in the second half of Feb 2024, please? What is the message for Scorpio? Okay, you've got choose to be happy. You've got the dog and you also have the hawk, and it's saying spirit is sending you messages. I do see a lot of messages between you and this person as well, so you can expect a message, you can expect to hear from them. But it says open your greater vision to see the signs, focus on priorities and eliminate distractions. You have a bright future. Let yourself ascend to new heights. Okay, nice. And I'm going to just pull one more card from this new deck of mine. Okay, oops, not this card. Let's see. What's the message for Scorpio? Message for Scorpio, second half of Feb 2024. You've got the arts, so creative energy, express yourself through creative activities. Interesting. All right. I hope this reading was helpful, Scorpio. Do leave me feedback in the comment section and I'll see you again soon. Bye.